Hey there, guys, what's going on? Tyler here with Your Movie Fix, and I'm doing something a little different. I didn't really feel like doing a spoiler discussion because I'm here with my friend Austin, who's a big Batman fan, and we talked about it ad nauseum, so we're not going to do a full spoiler discussion or anything like that, but we're going to do a top five Batman and top five Superman moments, and we're going to talk about all that here, which is when we're going to delve into all the spoiler stuff. So, starting with, this is my list, but I also wanted to get his commentary on things because he's a big Batman fan. Before we really get into it, what did you think of Ben Affleck in the movie as Batman and Bruce Wayne?
Best, easily the best Batman I've seen cinematically so far.
Yeah.
Easily best sounding. No disrespect to Kevin Conroy. I know I'm going to catch some flack.
No,
for that.
I
loved the voice changer in the suit. It did sound a little robotic, but I mean, it worked. He needs it so that people don't recognize him. And it's not Christopher Nolan's Batman where it's
it was
the gurgly.
It was a little over the top. It worked for it. I remember it was a shock when I first saw it in those Nolan movies, and I guess that you kind of get over it towards the last movie, but I guess it became a problem when it was kind of funny in pop culture to make fun of Christian Bale's Batman by talking like that. And I don't think the College Humor videos helped anything with that. I really like the robotic voice that he had too, and I also agree that this is the best cinematic Batman we've ever got. He was a total badass, creature of the night. You better be afraid of this guy when he's coming. They sold us very well on that. And what did you feel about the whole killing issue in this movie?
Two of my big things was using guns and him killing, and he does, as we know, both of those in this movie. So honestly, I was perfectly fine with it. This is a veteran Batman. This is a Batman who's gone the ropes, who's lost friends, who's obviously lost the Robin. I feel like he's ready to start killing.
It wasn't just straight up murder.
He wasn't murdering people. It was usually when he was either caught, like in the warehouse scene, when he was caught off guard with the people shooting him in the back of the head and just everything going on, and then he got the guy in the chokehold and pulled the assault rifle and whipped out and killed three of them right there.
Yeah, and even the guy that he had in the chokehold who had the gun, Batman wasn't pulling the trigger. He was just slinging a guy around who kept his finger on the trigger. And he was like, well, you know what? If that's his decision, then fuck it. That's what's going to happen.
Exactly.
I like that this Batman wasn't so black and white and hung up on someone got killed because of me. I think it's time we kind of got past that.
Exactly.
And, if you've seen the movie, I hope you've seen the movie before you watch this. There's even a part where the guy has a grenade and he drops it. And, Batman's like, that's not my problem. And he just goes around fighting while the guy, probably blows up and gets killed by that grenade.
Exactly.
I like that.
It was good. And he even used it to eliminate another one of the guys. It was the guy that was strung up.
He
shot him in the leg and strung him up, and which is awesome. We haven't seen any of that in any kind of cinematic thing.
And we'll get into that in just a moment about the warehouse stuff. And we're going to go into the top five right here. My top five moment was the nightmare, desert Batman scene. What do you think of that whole thing?
That was wonderful. It showed a more advanced Batman, he's used to having to kill people, because if we see, if you remember, as soon as he kicks open the back door of that, the Humvee, he jumps out and he's pistol whipping people. Just boom, boom, And it's right after that, he takes that guy's assault rifle and just starts, beat the shit out of everybody.
Yeah.
He just does not give a shit anymore, and he's using the assault rifle and shooting people.
Yeah, and that was a context with him using the guns that was fine, because you didn't know what the hell's going on. It's obviously in some weird nightmare. So that was okay. That was really the only time he was straight up killing anybody, a murderous. But I also thought that was kind of cool that was the first time we get a clear look at him in the movie. The first time you hear him speak as Batman is in the desert sequence with that whole thing. What do you think of the parademons?
Honestly, I felt the addition to them was good as you have the big Omega symbol out in the open field. And I think that the parademons are going to play a bigger part in something later. And it was a good little tease for people who knew what they were.
Yeah. Do you think we can get a callback to this scene and flashes, going back in time and warning him about Lois is the key? Do you think in Justice League 1 or 2 we can actually see them go back to something that's happening in the desert?
Well, you can either go one of two ways. You can go that way where they go back and they, and this future winds up becoming a reality, or Bruce winds up taking initiative, finds everybody, and they become this team and, you know, work around the fact that Lois is the key. So they try to do everything in their power to, you know, divert this other multiverse, you know, whatever it is. And, you know, then it just doesn't happen at all. Then it's more of like a warning.
Yeah.
Which I'd be okay with that, because then we still have our good Superman. He doesn't, you know.
Are you convinced that that was a nightmare or some kind of vision from the Flash? And some weird time ripple with him coming through?
That's easily just a time ripple. I wouldn't even call that like a
vision.
It's
hard to say.
I wouldn't call it a vision or a dream or anything.
Just
like
because
that.
Of all the dark side stuff. It's like, how would Batman know anything about that?
Exactly.
I feel like it would have to be some kind of weird time ripple. Moving on, we're going to go to my number four moment with the very end of the movie with Lex in his prison cell and Batman coming and talking to him and saying, like, wherever you go, whatever you do, I'm going to be watching you. I absolutely love that. And also, I really like the theme, his music in this. And it kicked in, like, the way the lights went out. Mm-hmm. And you just have, like, a shadow going over him. And even the lights went kind of red.
Yeah.
And
the emergency. Yeah,
the emergency lights kicked on. That was some beautiful imagery that Zack Snyder did. And you also know throughout this movie, he does the whole branding thing. And he makes a choice not to brand Lex Luthor in this. For whatever reason, you know, is he, you know, we hear him at the end of the movie say, men are still good. Mm-hmm. Do you think it was a conscious choice not to brand him because he doesn't feel like, you know, he needs to give out the death sentence sort of thing anymore? Or he feels like, I still need Lex. We still kind of need his brain. We need him for more information.
Exactly. I think that's what it is. I think he knows as soon as he brands somebody, that's the end. So he's basically...
Especially someone like Lex.
He's basically
responsible for killing Superman.
Yeah, he's basically... consciously killing people when he brands them, which I'm fine with. I love this brutal Batman, like I was saying, but I think that whole scene was just literally to scare the shit out of Lex. And I think he, you know, served his purpose.
Yeah, I think
like
he
as he's walking away and the camera's panning out and Lex is up against the bars, the bat symbol is imprinted in the brick wall behind him and it's still smoking. So, I mean, it's a very scary scene for Lex. He's got to be, you know, shitting himself.
Yes.
I mean, I would be. Yeah. So, I feel like he still wants him. He still wants to keep him alive because he knows as soon as he brands him, it's it. It's game over. And he knows that he's going to have to come back to him for more information.
Yeah.
On this being that's coming in you know, whatever.
And hopefully, like, in the ultimate cut, we could maybe see a little more on that because after he punches the wall, he basically disappears. And mm-hmm. I still liked it. I mean, it was an awesome, awesome Batman moment. But it would have been cool to see. Now, I think that was a glimpse of what an interrogation would be like with this version of Batman.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't be very fun, I don't think.
Oh, no.
All right, and going on to our number three moment. Well, this is my number three moment. He feels a little differently about it, but the Batman v Superman fight, what concludes the fight with Superman telling him we have to save Martha. Hearing Martha and, you know, Batman freaking out over the name Martha. How'd you know that name? Why'd you say that name? How did you feel about that whole thing?
Easily my number one moment. It strips Bruce down to his absolute core. And this is why it's my favorite moment. It takes all that brutality, his inhumanity gets pushed aside and he becomes human again. He becomes caring. He gets his heart back for this being who he's hated for... what, 2 years
now? Yeah, about around 2 years in this movie.
He's absolutely hated him, despised him. I mean, about to kill him. And so he's put all these resources into killing Superman. And then this one moment where it reminds him of his mother, it completely changes the game. Completely changes the game.
Yeah, and
I love it.
And it not only just kind of takes a shock to Batman just to hear that name and save Martha. And it cuts back very cleverly to his father Thomas laying on the ground saying Martha, and that's one of the last things that he remembers hearing. But on top of it triggering, you know, something weird in Batman's psyche, it's also a moment where Lois is coming in, and it totally humanizes this thing that he was about to kill that he thinks is just this overpowered god who can't connect to humanity. And next thing you know, he has a girlfriend and he has a mother, and his mother has the same damn name as me, or as my mom. And that didn't really sit well with people thinking, oh, that's such a silly reason to end the fight. If you understand these characters, if you know anything about Batman, That's a humongous deal. His parents, anything to do with his parents are like his biggest weakness, yeah. his go-to. If he has any leads on anything related to it, he chases after it. And hearing that name just set off a trigger in him. And I think exactly. it was a fantastic Batman moment and a great moment in the movie. So I don't think it was a stupid reason at all end the fight.
Me neither. I think it was perfect. Like I told you driving home, it was the best, easily the best moment in the whole movie for me. And the best moment, I feel like, for top five.
His
Batman.
Number one moment, and that was my number three. And going on to my number two, this is the first time we see him in the movie, the Batman's introduction that we see, that we've seen it in the trailers with the bats coming out of the chimney there. And in this, we see the cops going into this crime scene, and it's like a human trafficking thing. There's all these Asian girls down in the cellar, and like, it was the demon he saved us. It was this devil. And all the cops are just like, what the hell? They don't know what's going on. And they go upstairs, and we see the cop, and we get a shot of his face, and out of focus, out behind him, is Batman up on the wall, like a fucking creature in the night. That was so awesome, seeing him, just sprawled up on the wall, almost like Spider-Man. But it was so cool the way he, moves around the walls. Yeah. He was like a fucking demon, man. It was awesome.
It instantly reminded me of the movie Alien.
Yes. It was very so, alien. He was like a
so
xenomorph.
So dark. Everything in that scene was atmosphere. That whole scene, nobody could have said anything. There could have been no action, no nothing, but the atmosphere just completely set that whole scene. And then as you see him just up in the corner, and the way he even moves across the wall is just complete xenomorph. That's all I see.
And you got the cop freaking out, shooting at the walls and stuff. And not only did this version of Batman, not only does he fucking terrify the criminals, he scares the shit out of the cops, and he scares the people that he's saving, mm-hmm. even though he's got good intentions. But that was a pretty interesting spin. I still like that we were getting this demon-like Batman. I hope that, whatever's going on with a standalone Batman movie, whether or not it's a prequel or a sequel to these events, I'd still like to see a prequel done by Ben Affleck. And even if Ben Affleck isn't the one directing it, I still wouldn't mind seeing somebody like David Fincher, who did Gone Girl with him. They work very well together. And David Fincher does have, experience doing a type of movie like that. I think he could do an awesome crime thriller mm-hmm. with, a little more flavor of like a blockbuster, and doing some very Batman things like Zack Snyder did, borrow some of that, because Ben got to work with him. Even if you do a co-directing with David Fincher and Ben Affleck, that would be fantastic. But really liked his introduction in that scene. That was pretty damn awesome. And this is the number one moment for me. It's a number one moment for a lot of people. It was probably the most badass scene in the whole movie, was the warehouse rescue where Batman goes to save Martha for Superman. What did you think of that?
I've been waiting for a scene like this with Batman involved for my entire life. It was so good. He used every gadget in his arsenal. He used every technique. He stabbed people. He, deflected with the gauntlets. Mm-hmm. He used the cape. He used the zip lines. I mean, he was shooting people in the shoulder with his grapnel gun and jerking them over.
he threw him over to punch him. And it was Arkham. That was like Arkham... Yeah. Asylum Batman fighting style.
Exactly.
That was awesome. It was really funny. You brought it up earlier when we were first talking about it, like how he strings a guy up and then he ends up like roundhouse kicking him into somebody else, and that's the guy who drops the grenade. And that was just fucking awesome. And even like the way he used the grapple to like pull a crate and throw it over at somebody. And although like this was an awesome moment in the trailer, maybe they should have saved it for the movie. I mean, everybody was freaking out in this whole part. I mean, you could hear people talking during the scene just because of how awesome it was. He was freaking out. We saw this twice together. And I remember there was like some other guy, beside us just like, oh my God, just freaking out over this Batman. And, that was just so cool to finally get that fighting style. And it was a little bit of like, what Zach was able to do with Watchmen with the comedian Ozzy at the very beginning. But getting to see Batman fight and in a coherent scene, and you can tell what's going on, mm-hmm. this is certainly better than what Christopher Nolan was able to do in the Dark Knight movies. This was a martial artist Batman whooping some ass. It was pretty great. And going off of this, what did you think of the whole... Now, this was the only one that was a little more declarative of he probably did kill this guy with Anatoly Kanayazev, KG Beast. What did you make of that? When he, Dark Knight Returns, busting through the wall, grabs the gun.
I loved that part. I loved... You know what's going to happen, because it pans over, the camera's focused on obviously the guy who's focused on the door, but the camera's on him, so you know he's coming through the wall.
Yeah.
Somehow. And as soon as he got him, I was just like, oh, that is so cool. It was just like the arms coming through, and, you know, it was exactly like the animated movie from, you know, The Dark Knight Returns in the comic. And then with the machine gun, I didn't mind it. I didn't mind it. Again, it showed just how far he was willing to go to not let what happened to him happen to somebody else, being Superman. And, you know, doing anything he could to save, you know, parents, his mom, anything like that. It was good. It was needed. I feel like he needs to start killing. Now, he doesn't need to start doing...
He's not Rorschach.
He doesn't need to be Rorschach. He doesn't need to take meat cleavers to people's heads and, you know. But he does, I feel like, need to start killing people. But
they did it well because they didn't make him seem like a Red Hood or a Rorschach or a comedian. It was like... you could tell it's a Batman who kills.
And it was almost like a manslaughter kind of deal. With, I mean, he could have shot him. He could have shot, you know, KG Beast, or, you know, if he becomes that or whatever. And this is, although it wasn't a questionable thing of Batman's morality, did he kill? And this was even in the books with Batman, the first person that he like questionably killed, you know, post crisis, was KG Beast. He, like, you know, like, beat him to death or whatever. I think, was he set on fire? I'm not sure. But he, like, left him in an abandoned subway, mm-hmm. in some room, locked up to die. And it was basically retconned that he survived it, but because of what Batman did to him, he came back as this, you know, like, cyborg, basically, of, yeah. What's KG Beast, like, you know, like the bounty hunter kind of deal. And as a bonus, in that scene, after he actually saves Martha, the whole thing with... I'm a friend of your son's. Yeah. She's like, yeah, I could tell. It's the cape. Also really like that. Now, you didn't have any, you know, overall issues with the way that this Batman was characterized, what Zack Snyder did with him. You know, and like I said, this is Batman at the end of his line. He's seen a lot. Do you have any issues whatsoever with him?
I know a lot of people say that they don't like the humor. I felt like at some points, like, it was maybe a little forced. Like, you could tell, oh, they're going for a joke. It didn't seem really very natural. Like the Wonder Woman, when Wonder Woman comes in, and, oh, I thought she was with you. It was cool. It's nice banter. But
do you think if we would have seen more of a friendship between, yeah. Clark and Bruce, that line would have delivered better?
Yeah, exactly. But I don't think it really hit, you know, Bruce until, you know, after the end of the movie where he's, you know, talking to Wonder Woman. It doesn't hit him that they would have been great friends until that point. So there's no chance to really grow that friendship during that movie, because it was very,
very fast paced.
It was very, very, very fast paced. And that's not a complaint, but, you know, they didn't really have the chance to pan out their relationship. And I feel like that's a very, very important relationship in the Justice League, just because
They're the two big guns
besides Wonder Woman, but they're best friends. They're without a doubt best friends, and that's the Batman and Superman that I want to see in later movies, not, you know.
And I think that now we got the Versus stuff out of the way.
Yeah.
You know, their ideologies, they understand each other now. They fought a battle together. They were at least getting along then, and hopefully we do get to see that in Justice League 1 or 2, whatever they're going to end up doing. Who knows what the route they're going with that story? I don't know if you heard, but Zack Snyder said that. It is going to be Batman basically recruiting the other members of the League. I guess maybe him and Diana will be. But he said it was almost going to be like a Seven Samurai thing where he goes out,
yeah.
and looks for these people to help him. But yeah, those are just our top five moments, guys. His list may vary. Your list may vary. I want to know, comment down below, what are your top five moments? Do you agree with these? And what did you think of this version of Batman? This has been your Movie Fix. Be sure to look out for our top five Superman moments coming up. Be sure to subscribe for more movie news, movie reviews, editorials, and trailer breakdowns, all that good stuff. I'll see you on the next video.